Hello, I'm going to talk to you today about Splashup, which is a fully function, fully featured, advanced Web 2.0 image editor. I was really amazed to find this because, unlike Picnic and some of the others, this one has a lot of features. For example, this is the only Web 2.0 image editor I've ever seen that will work with layers. So we could sign up or sign in, but for now, let's just jump right in. And while it's loading, we'll talk about how this compares with some of the others. I've been impressed. This SplashUp compares to be similar, in my mind, to Paint.net, which is an open source downloadable program. I'm absolutely impressed by the results I've gotten by SplashUp. So here we will open a new image. We'll browse and let's see. Okay, here's one of me opening lighting a firecracker. So the first thing we notice is it's kind of blank. Well, that's actually because this is a very large image. So before we do anything else, let's resize the image. We'll click on constrain to keep the proportions the same, and then drop it down to about around 500 pixels. All right, now you'll see that the info here will tell you where your mouse is. You've got your color bar, and you can change not only the color, the shade, but also the transparency or the alpha in order to give yourself a sort of like a wash effect where the color is over it, somewhat like a watercolor, but not obscuring it. And can do a fill, let's see, or a marker, a large marker in this size, and we'll see that with this opacity, you're getting a very different effect than if you had a full opacity, which would be something like this. And we will undo both of these. And again, we've got the toolbar that everyone would be familiar with from every other image editor. But this is something interesting for a Web 2.0 tool, is that it has these movable bars, the toolbar, the info bar, that you would normally see on installed software. We'll look briefly at the layers tool. This allows you to add layers, remove layers. You can actually take a selection and then copy it to a new layer. If you were to use the lasso tool to take, say, my head, and then you could copy it to a new layer, and here you have a new layer that just has my head on it. If you click the eyeball closed, it will make the current layer sort of disappear, and you see on this new layer it's just the selection. Now if you were to use move and then just click on move, make sure you're working with the right layer, and then drag it over. Then if you open this, you will see that the layer has been moved, and you've got two of my head floating around. Now, doing silly things with the heads cut from photos is really not the highest and best use of layers, but I think this is not really the place to talk about the kinds of things you can do with image editing software. But this layers tool is an incredibly powerful thing for photo editing, and this is the first Web 2.0 tool I have seen that has it, and I'm extremely impressed by that. SplashUp has all kinds of filters. You can sharpen, you can blur, you can posterize, you can do all kinds of different things. that you would normally not see that much of in Web 2.0. Now, some of these are common, and Picnic does them. But again, the layers is the most important thing, and I'm really impressed by the quality of the layers interface in SplashUp. I'm just, honestly, I'm impressed by the fact that it even does layers. So that's just a basic overview. You've got some things like you can capture a picture from a webcam. You've got undo and redo commands. Basically, all of the major things that you need. You can flatten the image so that the two layers go together as one. We'll undo that. You can zoom. There's even a help feature. So you really have a tremendous amount of power that I've really never seen before in a Web 2.0 tool. Thank you.